Hello. No doubt, as part of the language program, will be readers. So, in your classroom, you will have many different readers on many different subjects, many different reading levels, and here are just some of them. Make sure that you've got some sort of a system that the children have a special book bag or something like that to take home some of their reading equipment and read through it together with their parents or with a pair or by themselves or with a friend or something like that. But reading is a good thing. Basically, through reading, the children will be realizing themselves how to write certain words and how to not write certain words, how to pronounce certain words that don't make sense, like Wednesday, which is Wednesday. Things like that they will find through reading. Additionally, reading is great to find more information, to gain a greater vocabulary, and to be able to inform others or themselves about topics that they might not have thought about. Then there's different literature. There's humorous literature, for example, dead snoring. There is literature about festivals, Matariki. My favorite are these kind of readers about real things, butterflies, beetles. I really love real literature. And there's also something about trains. There's something about a real life situation we are having in our life where if we don't want to talk to nanny or granddad, we have to do it through a computer. So there's this one. Could be a bit more up to date looking at the pictures, but not too bad. Look. Apple. But the child might not know that. But they probably will. So here's what other ones are there? Let me see. There's another one I wanted to show. So sparking conversation. Look at this one. Greedy cat's door. It's about a cat that is looking at having Christmas, eating lots of Christmas things from the table he's not supposed to have, so he doesn't fit through the door anymore. The solution be I'm sorry. This cat's face. Never mind. The cat's not so happy either. So it took out the whole door trying to get out into freedom, not being blamed for eating the Christmas pudding. Solution being the cat is getting a dog door. So obviously I think it's very funny. Some people might think that's not funny at all. Some people might have a problem with the conversation of weight gain and might not think that's appropriate reading at all. So I guess if, when you have these kind of books, be aware what's in them and have a talk about it. You know, don't expect the children to be critical just by themselves on their own without having a partner. But you know, when you see them choosing this one, have a talk with them about it afterwards. Ask them some open questions. Get them talking. Get them thinking, reflecting. You know, if you don't like the ending of this book, you could say, well, what else could they have done? Or maybe they could have, you know, put that cat on a decent feeding program and get him a cat scratcher instead of a bigger dog, a bigger cat door. So that might have worked too. But oh, I love that book. Let's have another look at those pictures. Trying to help the cat to get through the door. We know where that ends up. Never mind. So there's humorous books, which are great as well. You will have seen big reading books. Let me have a look at one that I'm not really sure about what to think. So here we have some big books. And that is this one. So there's many big books, but this book is basically about an ant and the grasshoppers, and through different things that happen and the seasons changing, towards the end, the grasshoppers are very cold and they would like to have some food, wondering where the ant is. And what the ant did with all the supplies made themselves some pretty good corn pancakes. So, which is very sneaky, isn't it? I think the kids will like the sneaky part of it, and that's great conversation. I personally find this book only suitable for older children, meaning, well, once they come to you, they're 6 years anyway, aren't they? But even when they are 6 years of age, you might just want to point out that it's not actually realistic that an ant is making corn pancakes underground. And that the animals are talking is not really something what's realistic either. Because they're talking in a communicative way that might be not exactly information exchange which grasshoppers are having. And I'm not sure if they talk to ants at all. I don't think so. I think actually the ant will try to hunt a grasshopper down if it's too close to its home. So just make sure that when it's a not realistic book, the children know about it. But in general, perfect for conversation, right? I mean, I can talk about this already forever, and I'm not even supposed to talk so long on this video. So have fun with books, have fun with the readers. I know there's different level of readers. Encourage children to go beyond of what, you know, what you think their reading level is, and have conversations, assist them, make them have good experiences, allow them to succeed, set them up for success. Have fun.